Hey everybody, it's Sean and Trey with Reactions to the Classics. Before we get started today, we just wanted to invite you to take a look at our Patreon page where we have all kinds of reward tiers, anywhere from reacting to an entire album to songs, supporting us for as little as $1 a month. It really helps us out.
And you can also check out our Facebook and Discord groups down below. Got a great community of people who love music. And all that to say, y'all, let's get to today's video.
What's going on, everybody? Sean joined again by my son, Trey. And today at Reactions to the Classics, we have a song reaction to I'm Mandy Fly Me by 10cc. For our patron, Daniel. Now, Trey, we did a 10cc song recently.
Yes, we did I'm Not in Love, which was just fantastic.
Fantastic. That was one of those musical journeys, as I like to say. This song comes a little bit later. It's from 1976, and it went to number 6 in the UK off their How Dare You album. And the story behind this is they saw a poster up in an airport for National Airlines, and there was a good-looking stewardess, as in their words, and he said her name wasn't Mandy, it was Cindy or something, but there was a homeless guy sitting underneath it, staring up there at it, and he thought, you know what, there's a song here, because he thought it had a double meaning, the airplane and something else, and he said that homeless guy was looking at her thinking, I'm never going to have a chance to fly that airplane except for in my dreams. So that's how this song came about, and that's all I know about it. I've never heard it, but I thought it was as always, that we come across a lot of interesting songwriting stories, and there's another one.
That's why I like to hear the backgrounds of these, because that is definitely a noteworthy.
It is
a noteworthy background. So we'll have the lyrics pulled up here. Be reading along. Give a little thoughts as the music's playing, but save our kind of full-on articulated thoughts once the song ends. So let's get these headphones on and let's get rocking. See, I'm already loving this touch here.
Only in the wet. Now the airplane's coming from my right ear, left my way.
Man, I love their studio painting effects.
Just like a rolling stone, I'm outside looking in. But if your chance came, would you take it? Where on earth do I begin? I'm struck a chord with a smile as bright as sunshine. She called me through the poster and welcomed me aboard. She led me, she fed me, she read me like a book. I'm hiding in the small print. When you take another look and take me away, try me, Mandy, fly me away.
The world was spinning like a ball, and then it wasn't there at all. And as my heart began to
as we heard on I'm Not in Love,
yeah,
so well arranged.
very low, man.
Loving this instrument. Coda was a little throwback to the instrumental we had in the middle of the tune.
Yeah, man. Excellent intro and outro. Nice and faded in and out. I don't know if that's the actual poster they have on Genius. The boys from 10cc said her name was Cindy or something. There's a poster on a picture here on Genius of I'm Cheryl Fly Me. So that's had to be what they were looking at. But I mean, there could have been several different ones. Cindy, Cheryl, whoever. But I don't think Cheryl or Cindy would have sounded as good as Mandy. But... wow, yeah, this one was quite the dichotomy in tempo, right? The song itself is very chilled and slow, but then the middle two guitar solos interlaid on top of each other, like up tempo in the middle of it, and then we dial it back out.
Yeah, there are times where it's very very light, spacey, floaty, kind of in the beginning, and then the tempo shifts. That guitar riff there in the middle,
right.
Much faster pace. I did like the imagery as well evoked in this. You really kind of get an image in your head of a woman who's just, you know, almost unattainable.
Right, exactly.
In a sense, which as you start reading the line, she called me through the poster, so obviously this is not a real woman, but then this guy is kind of led to his own type of fantasy. She read me like a book, but I'm hiding in the small print. Won't you take another look? I like that. This guy feels like he's, kind of just on the outs. He can't be seen. So I really, really enjoyed that. I felt Mandy pull me up as we get into the third verse. Give me the kiss of life, just like the girl in Dr. No, No, No.
Throw out to James Bond.
Is that right? Okay?
Yeah, Dr. No, first Bond movie. So, and then they finish it out at the bottom. I told them so, but they said no, 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 no. I think the star of this song is the arrangement, the instrumentation. Mm-hmm. I think obviously we have some nice harmonies and the songwriting is fine, but for me, the instrumentation is where it was all about.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, we got the synths in there, a vibraphone.
And they phoned nothing in. I can tell just from the two songs. They phoned nothing in on the arrangement and production. It is expertly done.
Absolutely. So I this didn't hit the level of I'm Not in Love
but
I didn't expect it to.
No, I didn't either.
But this was definitely a good kind of second song reaction to
so
do.
So what do you give?
I'm feeling a very solid 8 on this one.
8? I'm going to be at a 7.75 just because it is so wonderfully arranged instrumentally and obviously the harmonies and those sorts of things are fantastic. So another good one brought to us by a patron. This is one after another. But thank you, Daniel, absolutely, for bringing that to us.
Yeah, and if you guys have any other 10cc suggestions or just...
or anything else.
Yeah, give us your thoughts as well on the song down below. And be sure to hit that big thumbs up as well as that red subscribe button we upload every single day. And until next time, y'all, thank you so much for watching. Happy listening, and we will see you.